things I'm interested in, I think we're all interested in, and you would be in a prime position to help, is if one looked at your constituency, and I mean in that sense your political constituency as well as medical, how would you describe the needs of that constituency? I know this is a global question, but what type of constituency is it, and what is it that needs to be met in that constituency?
Well, perhaps the defining points for the purpose of today are almost 50% were of migrants born outside the UK. Although it has very wealthy pockets, it also has some of the most deprived areas of the UK contained within it. It has high levels in the census data of chronic illnesses, things like diabetes, HIV, and it has a lot of people with multiple health problems who need a lot of attention from, and often attention that can only be provided at consultant level, which is not to say that lots of GPs don't do a very good job, but there are acute health needs there. But the other thing, if there is a turnover of various estimates between a quarter and a third of the population a year, which means that people, far more so than other parts of the country, even other parts of London, people are not registered with GPs. If they do fall ill, then their point of recourse is the accident emergency department. Now that is one reason why urgent care and indeed GP services are available. Because we're trying to anticipate that problem. There's nothing you can do about that. We can't stop that population mobility. A lot of it will be, for example, poor people, people seeking low-paid jobs, migrant communities of that kind. Their healthcare needs must be met, and it is both more expensive and it requires a different type of response to a very stable community where people will go through a more orthodox process of simply getting their GP and doing